In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about Platform Effector 2D. So let's look at it with an example. In this project, I have a box. This box has rigid body 2D and box glider 2D attached to it. I have also attached a jump script. This jump script will make this box jump up and down when I press the space bar, and will make it go left and right when I press left and right arrow keys. In this project, I have a wooden plank. Now this plank has a rigid body 2D attached whose body type is kinematic, and it has a box glider 2D attached to it. I'll just demonstrate for you. So this is how it's currently working. So the platform effector 2D is basically used for one-way collisions. I'll demonstrate that. One-way collisions happen when you go under any game object, you jump from beneath, you pass right through this game object, you go on top, and then you land on top of this game object. So let's try and achieve that effect right here. I'll select the plank, click on add component, and write platform effector 2D. Immediately it gives a warning, the effector will not function until there is at least one enabled 2D collider with used by effector checked. So what you need to do is you just need to tick this used by effector checkbox, and immediately you can see that there is an arc that appears on top of this game object. When I run this, and if I try to jump from below, you will see that I jumped from below, I went right through the wooden plank, and then I landed on top. Now when I jump on it, you will see that I'm landing on that log. So this is what one-way collision is all about. Now let's look at some of the properties. The first property we use is the use collider mask. If by default you keep it unchecked, then this platform effector will use the global collision matrix for the collisions. But if you check it, you can edit the values inside this collider mask properties. Now inside this collider mask, you will have the various layers. So it will collide with all the layers. I have created my own layer, top and top one. So currently if I select the box game object, the box layer is top one. So if I want that this wooden log should not collide with this box, all I can do is I can click on the plank, go to this collider mask drop down, and untick this top one. So now this wooden log will interact with all the colliders except for those that are in the layer top one. I run this. So now you can see that this wooden log does not interact with this box. I'll set it back to everything. Now the next property is the rotational offset. So the rotational offset basically means on which side of this plank you want the collisions to happen. The side with the arc on it is the side that the collisions normally happen. But if you want that the collisions should happen from below, all you can do is you can just change the angle. So here in this example, I can change this value to say 180. So this gets inverted. Now if I run this, you can see that if I try to jump from below, it collides with this surface, and the side with which it won't collide is the top side. So this is what the rotational offset is used for. Now the next property is one way, and inside this you have the use one way property, which is currently ticked. This platform will exhibit a one way collision. Now if suppose I untick it and run this project, you will see that that effect won't take place. I'll reset this back. Now the next property is use one-way group. The use one-way grouping is used when you have a game object that has multiple colliders on it and you want them to interact with this wooden log as a single unit. Next property is the surface arc. The surface arc property defines the surface on which the collisions will take place. So currently it's set to 180 degrees. That means the entire top part will be a collision part and the sides too will be the collision part. So if I run this again, you will see that the collisions happen on the top, also the collisions happen from the sides. So you can see that it's colliding with the sides. Now if you don't want this box to collide with the side of this wooden log, then all you need to do is change the surface arc angle. So here's for example, I change this to 70. So now it will only interact with the top part. Let's check it out. I jump on top, it interacts, and I collide with the sides, it doesn't interact. Now the next property is the sides. Now the sides property is used when you want this game object sides to interact in a different manner than how they interact on the top. So for example, currently the use side friction has been set to null and the use side bounce has been set to null. So in order to understand this, I have created a physics 2D material called friction, and this friction's property has 5 as its friction value and 0.5 as its bounciness value. I have attached that friction to the material slot in the box glider 2D of the wooden plank. So basically this entire thing will exhibit the property of that material. That is, it will have a bounce and it will have some friction. Currently the side friction is not ticked and the side bounce is not ticked. That means if I run this, and interact with the sides. So when I land on top, it bounces, but when I land on the sides, it doesn't bounce. It just goes right through. If you want that this box, when it collides with the side, even then it should bounce or exhibit friction, then what you can do is you can change the property here. So I'll set first this use side bounce. Let's run it. So you can see that now it's bouncing on the sides. Also, if you want the side to exhibit friction, I'll untick this bounce and I'll tick on this side friction and run it. I go to the sides, I collide against it. You can see that it's coming down slowly. It's exhibiting friction. And finally, the side arc property, how much angle of the sides you want this property to show its behavior. Now, if you have any other whose sides are carved out to an angle, then you can specify that angle here. So I hope you understood this tutorial about Platform Effector 2D.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.